First of all, what is elastic collision? The principle of conservation of momentum states that when no external forces act on a system consisting of two objects that collide with each other, the total momentum of the system before the collision is equal to the total momentum of the system after the collision. We can conclude that the total momentum before and after the collision is equal. So, P initial is equal to P final. And remember, both momentum and kinetic energy are conserved in elastic collision. Alright, from the previous slide, we know that P initial is equal to P final. Thus, M1V1 plus M2V2 is equal to M1V1 plus M2V2. For the velocity, at the left-hand side, we know that it is initial velocity of the object, which is before the collision happened. While the velocity at the right-hand side is the final velocity of the objects, which is after the collision happened. This formula can help us to find the velocity of both objects after and before the collision. Next, we can see the example of elastic collision in our life. Alright, when a ball at a billiard table hits another ball. From the first diagram, which is before the collision happened, the 13 ball initially travels to the right while the 8 ball is stationary. During the collision, the 13 ball exert a force on the 8 ball that gets it moving, but the 8 ball also exert a force on the 13 ball that slow it down. Alright, so both of the ball exert a force to one another. Alright, after the collision, we can see that because of this collision, the 13 ball stops or continues moving slowly and the 8 ball is accelerated. Okay, this is the example of elastic collision in our life.
Hi, now I want to share about inelastic collision. So, if two objects stick together as a result of the collision is called inelastic. In this case, the kinetic energy is not conserved. Why? This is because the total final kinetic energy is less than the total initial kinetic energy due to convert to the internal energy, sound energy, and into the work needed to deform an object. However, the momentum of the system is still conserved. So, as you can see from the equation, compared to the diagram, so we see before the collision, M1 times V1I plus M2 times V2I equal to after the collision, M1 plus M2 times V, which is they both have final velocity and attach each other. And now we go to the example of inelastic collisions. So the two cars before the collision and after the collision. So the two cars after the collision, they attach each other and have same velocity. So this is what we call the example of inelastic collision in our daily life. So as we can see from the equation, M1 times V1I plus M2 times V2I equal to M1 plus M2 times V. Why? This is because the after collision, they are attached each other and then they have the same velocity for the two object. That's why the after collision is M1 plus M2 times V.
Okay guys, next we will jump straight into glancing collision. What is glancing collision? Glancing collision is the collision occur when objects collide in different direction. Yeah, when we want to calculate the total momentum before collision and after collision, we need to consider it separately for x and y component. For example, when we want to calculate the total momentum before collision for x component, we have to equal it with the total momentum after collision and also of x component. Yeah, same thing goes with y component. The total momentum y component before collision and equal to the y component of total momentum of y component. Yeah, like that. We cannot simply just equal x and y and x. Yeah, that's wrong. We need to x with x, y and y. Yeah. Okay, next, we will look for the example of glancing collision. Just as what we can see on the slide, which is the simplest example for glancing collision is when we are playing pool. Yeah, we don't simply strike the ball, the white ball and the colored ball parallelly, no, or in the same path, same direction. We need to make an angle so that our colored ball will fall into the hole that we exactly want.
The nucleus of an atom has a mass of 3.8 times 10 to the power of negative 35 kilograms and is at rest. The nucleus is radioactive and suddenly ejects a particle of mass 6.6 times 10 to the power of negative 37 kilograms at a speed of 1.5 times 10 to the power of 7 meters per second. Find the recoil speed of the nucleus that is left behind. So P initial is zero because it is at rest, the atom is at rest, and P final equal to M1V1 and plus M2V2. So we know that P initial equal to P final. So 0 equal to M1V1 plus M2V2, and we solve for the V1 because we want to find the V1. So when we solve for the V1, we get V1 equal to M2V2 over M1. So this is the value, M2V2 over M1, which here from the previous question, M2, which is 6.6 times 10 to the power of negative 27 times V2, 1.5 times 10 to the power of 7 here over M1. M1 is 3.8 times 10 to the power of negative 35. So we just solve it and calculate, and we get negative V1 equal to 2.61 times 10 to the power of 5 meters per second.
We're going to continue to the question 2. The question given is a 15,000 kilogram railroad car traveling at speed of 22 meters per second strikes an identical car at rest. If the cars lock together as a result of a collision, what is their common speed afterward? So, based on the question given here, we know that this type of collision is inelastic. Why we say so? This is because the question said that the result of a collision is the cars lock together. So, we know that that is the hint for the type of inelastic collision. So, how to solve this problem? Okay, this is the sketching of the diagram for the solution. So we know that from the conservation of momentum, P initial is equal to P final. So the formula given is M1V1 plus M2V2 for the initial momentum, and for the final momentum, the V final times M1 plus M2. So the question wants us to find the common speed of the collision, so it can represent as V final. So after we substitute all the formula, for the mass is 15,000 kilogram times with 22 meters per second, and with the car at rest is 0, and then we will get the final answer is 11 meters per second. So nowadays we know that the accident of any transportation is increases. So we need a material in order to solve this kind of problem. So one of the way that scientists find is using airbags. So let's jump straight to the question. Airbags in automobiles reduce what in a collision? What is your answer? The answer is actually B, the forces exerted upon the passenger. Why we say so? This is because we know that the formula of for impulse forces is impulse forces equal to mv minus mu over t. So when we're using airbags, we can delay or we can increases the time between the passengers and the steering of the car to collide each other. So we know that from the formula, we know that T, the time, is inversely proportional to the impulse forces. So when we delay when we increase the time between the passenger and the steering of the car to collide, then we will reduce the forces. So the final answer or the exact answer is B,